I thank God for the life of our registrar and of your strength, and appreciate all the executive. The wonderful shows to me you are really, really hungry for God. And the Bible says, blessed are they that have hunger for righteousness, for they will not be starved, but they shall be filled. And I know for sure you shall be filled in the name of the Lord Jesus. Can we quietly open our Bible into the book of Daniel, chapter number 6? We want to give ourselves challenge. We are born, or we are created to dominate. And if you look at that word, kingdom, is a combination of two words, kings and domain, or a king in dominion. Scripture said, he has made all of us king and priest unto God, and we shall reign where? On earth. Praise God. So God wants his will to be done in our nation. He wants his will to be done in our lives. He wants his will to be done in our families. God wants our life to be precious. He wants the earth to be a peaceful. Jesus Christ said, you are the light of the world. The city that is set on a hill that can never be what? You are unheedable. When you get to a place and there is darkness, what you need is light. Light illuminates. God wants us to influence everywhere. He wants us to influence our hostess. He wants us to take over everyone. And because you are in that family, God wants them to see everything clearly. I know some of you are going to go into politics. When you get there, what do you want to become? Take the kingdom there. Some of us are going to be in the medical world. Some of us are going to be in different places in offices. What did God want you to become? He wants you to become light. Somebody say, I'm the light of the world. Shout it, let me hear your voice. I said in the scripture yesterday, the Bible says these things happened and they were written for what? For our example. So we want to look at one example today in the book of Daniel chapter 6 and give you a challenge there to go and take over in the heart. That's why he prayed for us and said, do not take them away from the world, but that you keep them from evil in the world. That is from verse 1. The Bible said that it pleased Darius to set over the kingdom 120 princes, which should be over the whole kingdom, and over these 3 presidents, of whom Daniel was first. The king Darius wanted to arrange his kingdom, maybe local government by local government. And then he decided to arrange for 120 princes to take over. He chose 3 of them and divided the local government to 3 zones. And out of the 3 that he chose, Daniel was better than one of them. I want you to understand that as a kingdom citizen, you are not like every other person. You are a peculiar person. A holy nation. That's who you are. The Bible says, and on that day, I'm going to put the distinction between him that serveth me and he that does not serve me. About all these presidents, he was not just among the 120 princes. He qualified about them. When they chose the president to oversee those ones, the Bible said Daniel was first, and I declared everything you'll be first. You are not answering me this morning. I said you will be first. The word of the Lord says you will be the first and not the last. It's our covenant. You are not born to be the tail, you are born to be the head. You shall. He didn't say you may. He didn't even say you will. He said you shall be the head and what? And not the tail. As a kingdom citizen, you are born to be there. And I want to challenge you, everywhere you are, righteously have a vision. You have to get to the top. Righteous. You don't have to push somebody else up before you want to, because you want to write. Are you still with me? Verse 2, and over these 3 presidents, of whom Daniel was first, that the princes might give account unto them, and the king should have no damage. Then this demon was preferred above. And I prayed over your life. In everything you will lay your hands upon, you will be preferred above. You remember when Joseph brought out his interpretation to Pharaoh? The Bible said, and the word of Joseph was good unto Pharaoh.
If they want to try to test whether what he said was true or not, they have to wait at least the first 7 years. His prophecy was about 40 years. There's going to be first 7 years of plenty, then there's going to be 7 years of famine. And he said, this and this is what you have to do. But when he spoke, as he was speaking, there was something that rested upon him. It's called favor. The Bible said, and the word of Joseph was good unto Pharaoh. And Pharaoh said, no one is as wise and discreet as you are. Therefore, you shall be the prime minister. Only in throne will I be greater than you. To be lifted and promoted is not just by effort, it's actually by favor. No matter what you know to do, no matter the kind of skill you have, make sure that you live a life that God can give you favor. The Bible said that in the land of Babylon, the king said that he gathered all the beautiful women. And when they gathered Esther to register, he was a slave there, but he registered. And the Bible says that when Esther appeared, the context was over. The king said, this is what I want. I believe she was not only, she wasn't the most beautiful, naturally, but there was something upon you, upon her life, called favor. That favor will rest upon you. People of the kingdom will carry favor. The Bible said, and Daniel was preferred out above. There are people that are favored. There are people that were highly favored. You remember Mary? The angel appeared to Mary and said, you are highly favored above all women. So there are people that were favored and there are people that were highly favored. You are highly favored. What was the factor that was determining the happenings in the life of Daniel? Let's read for that. Verse 3, are we still there? Then this Daniel was preferred above the president and the princes. The cause was an excellent spirit was in him. And the king thought to set him over the whole land. So number one thing that you needed in order to take over as a citizen of the kingdom, you need the excellent spirit. That's the Holy Spirit. Somebody say the Holy Spirit. Talk to me, church. Say the Holy Spirit. Jesus said to his disciples, he said, tarry ye in Jerusalem until you be endued with what? With power from on high. When the Holy Spirit moves with you, joins you, Jesus said, I'm going to send you another comforter. Another comforter means another helper, the one that takes hold with you, the one that assists us. Because of an excellent spirit. Let me ask you this. The activities around your life, can people trace it to the Holy Spirit? The kind of habits and lifestyle that you bring out, you actually claim that you actually come from church. You actually come from us. Paul said there are some who claim to be part of us, but they are not from us. Can people trace their things? It was a weakness from the unbelieving nation. When they look critically into the life of Daniel, they could summarize it as his spirit in this life. What spirit do you carry? There are people that carry the spirit of death. There are people that carry the spirit of failure. There are people that carry the spirit of suicide. Every day just thinks of when he sees a car, he wants to run across. There's a spirit pulling. If anybody is under that strange spirit, today the power of God set you free. I said today that power of God set you free. Number one thing that you must carry with you is the spirit of God. Excellent spirit. You can't carry that spirit and be the last in class. You can't carry that spirit and be a dollar. We have a sound mind. The Bible says we have the mind of Christ. Do you think that if Christ is in your school, what position do you think that he's going to take? Talk to me. Praise God. Do you understand what I'm talking about? Let's read on. So number one, write it down. The Holy Spirit. Take the Holy Spirit as a citizen of the kingdom to affect everywhere you are. It will affect every area of your life. Physically, spiritually, maritally. You saw what Pastor shared with us. I saw the picture of that accident. I think it was last year he showed it to me. I saw it. Only God can escape him. It is the power of the Holy Spirit. Did you hear what I said?
Let's read further. Verse 4, the Bible said, then the president and the princes sought to find an occasion against Daniel concerning the kingdom, but they could not find none occasion nor fault. Why? For as much as he was what? Faithful. And let me tell you, if you are going to affect a generation, your campus, as a citizen of the kingdom, you need diligence and faithfulness. Diligence. When we talk about diligence, diligence is not just a factor that unbelievers have, but it's an attitude to work. It's an attitude to your study. You can't abandon your study and change something else. You can't abandon your study and start talking around the hostel. The Bible says when this happened, they are, because you need to understand, if you are a citizen of the kingdom, Jesus Christ said, because the world hates me, they will hate you too. And he said, we are in the world, but you are not of the world. So if you are not of the world, you must express persecution. Jesus Christ said, in the world, you shall have what? Tribulation. But be of good cheer, for what? I have overcome the world for you. You are going to have trouble, tribulation. They will try to challenge you. Book of James chapter 5, chapter 1, verse 2 and 3. He said, brethren, rejoice and count it all joy when you fall into diverse kinds of temptation. He said, for the trying of your faith is not a trying of your strength. It's not because you are a sinner, it's because you actually have faith. Why did the persecution, the trouble of Job came in those days? The Bible says, God said unto Satan, have you observed my servant Job? He's a faithful man. And that was what landed him in trouble. He's a faithful man. The people of the world, the devil will test your faithfulness. It's going to test your Christianity. If your Christianity has to undergo test machine, what will you become? Will you drop it or you are still going to become that? One of the ladies that she has challenged believers in this nation is a lady called Leah Shari. How many of you still remember? May the Lord bring that young girl out of the captivity of the Boko Haram. Even some pastors will deny it. And go ask for sin later, for forgiveness of sins later. Be diligent. The Bible says, sin a man. He didn't say, see a Christian. He says, sin a man. Diligent in what? In his business. He shall not stand before ordinary men. He shall stand before kings and before great men. So stand before men. Number one, the Holy Spirit is another additional factor for you as a citizen of the kingdom. But you need to understand this power of diligence. I've never seen a tailor that you give clothes to and people know that that tailor, he actually is very good at his job, but you can actually have the assurance the day you want your clothes is not the day you are going to get it. I've never seen people like that. You have seen a car that you give them your car. No matter what, even if it is plugged, one of them must lose. He knows the job. He has the skill, but he's not diligent. Have you ever seen somebody that says in a particular place? Everybody knows that that product you will have it, but you always come late. Don't let it be that you are the one that comes late to class. Be diligent. Diligence must be our lifestyle as a citizen of the kingdom. Jesus Christ said, my Father walketh, either so I walk also. If God is working and Jesus is working, why should you be sleeping? Somebody say, I'll be diligent. Talk to me. I'm not hearing you. Make that decision. Romans chapter 12, verse 11. He said, don't be slothful in business. Be fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. Don't be lazy. He said, the lazy man will not sow in the time of rain. He said, and therefore you shall bear. Don't happen. You will not bear. I said, you will not bear. Be diligent with your study. Be diligent. Make a decision. What do you want to bring out of this campus? And then begin to walk towards it. Now you have the Holy Spirit to assist you. One of the benefits you have with the Holy Spirit is that it can show you where to study. It can show you what the lecturer is going to say. I'm telling you. In the book of Psalm 119, David said in verse 99 and 100, he said, I have understanding more than my teacher. Because your presence and my meditation, I have understanding more than. When you have the Holy Ghost, you are still at better advantage.
So number one, you must carry the Holy Spirit. Operate the Holy Spirit. Cooperate with the Holy Spirit. Number two, you must create the lifestyle and attitude of diligence. You saw it. I had it yesterday. When pastor was saying, everybody don't wait, just go and then some people still waited. That's diligence in their business. May the Lord bless you and the world you pray to. Some other people will complain. It's humanly enough to release you as a leader, but they felt this has to be done. Diligence will give you the urgency of the matter. And a person that is not diligent will be possessed with the spirit of procrastination. I will eat later. I will do it later. That's why many people are never saved. He thinks he's procrastinating his salvation. The Bible said they were looking for an occasion in order to rob this man off and report him to the king. His account was okay. He never invested money. When they came, they put somebody behind his office watching. 7:30 is the resumption hour. Watching. If he is late 1 minute, call us. We will call the king. They were there. He's opposed to his room by 7:30. By 7, his car was coming. He said, this guy is the person that they set out to watch him so that they can rob Daniel. Before that guy comes, he saw his office open. So how are we going to capture this guy? They secretly packed his account. Everything was intact. He said, this is serious. Even we that were born in this land, we know what we have invested. If God gives you an opportunity to join politics, what will you become? I still believe that we need to raise believers that are disciples. Who will go there and think what is going on? Not just church goers. Who will go there and join them? Praise God. We need people that are going to faithfully serve the people. Diligence. Somebody say diligence. Number three, you need to be faithful. Let's look for that. The Bible says he was faithful, neither was there any error or fault found in him. That's fine. Then said this man, we shall not find any occasion against this man, this day, except we find it against him concerning the law of his God. Then this president, princes, assembled together to the king, and said thus unto him, King Darius, live forever. All the presidents of the kingdom, the governors, the princes, and the counselors, the captains, have consulted together to establish a royal statute to make a firm decree that whosoever shall ask a petition of any god or man for 30 days, save of the king, okay, he shall be cast into the den of lions. Now, okay, establish the decree and sign the writing that it be not changed according to the law of Medes and Persians, which uttered it not. Therefore, King Darius signed the writing and the decree. Are we still together? Verse 10 now. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his windows being open, in his chamber towards Jerusalem, he knelt down on his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God. Look at the last phrase. What? As he did aforetime. You must be a devotee if you are going to make it as a kingdom city. If you are going to affect a nation, you must be what? A devotee. Let me tell you, when you get yourself devoted to something, you put the spirit behind it. Do you hear what I say? If you choose this pillar, I said every morning I will keep going to this pillar and begin to say some words. If you keep doing it, if you do it consistently for a period of time, you begin to sense that something strange begins to happen around this pillar. Everywhere there is a devotion, a spirit is always attracted. The Bible said when the decree was signed, do you understand what we are reading? Are we together? He said when the decree was signed, they signed that nobody should pray to any other god except the king. I don't know how much power the king is that is going to answer the prayer of everybody. And the Bible said when the king was signed, Daniel went into his room and opened the window. Listen to me. He was not trying to dare the king, but he was not able to compromise his faith. Many times we try to dare. Let me explain this to you. If you work in a particular place that they said You work in a place that you don't carry Bible to the place. I'm just giving you an example. You don't always you don't carry Bible to your working place. You just go. And then suddenly they brought a decree and said, no Christian should carry Bible here. If you don't carry it, you are not saying. You are not compromised, because before you don't use them. But if you used to carry Bible, and because they see you, they made a decree that nobody must bring Bible here. If you carry it, you are not bearing them. You only decide not to compromise your faith. The Bible says Daniel went and opened the window. He could have closed it. If he closed it, that would be a compromise. If you have to face your test, the Bible says, and fire, every man's faith shall be tested with fire, to know what sort it is. If God is going to test your faith with fire, what will you become? The Bible says some people, their work will be burned down. Their faith will be burned down. Because everything he has been carrying for years is nothing but what? Tradition. Don't be a traditionalist. Be a citizen of the kingdom. Traditions don't last. The Bible says by your tradition you have made the word of God to be of what? No effect. Praise God, somebody. Don't try to compromise your faith. Know God. And get yourself devoted to Him. Daniel decided, he went there and opened the window. I'm not going to close it. To close it means he was afraid of the law of the king. To close it means he was trying to look for an escape route from the rest of people that were trying to persecute him. And let me tell you, a citizen of the kingdom cannot be persecuted. Everyone that is looking for your downfall will fall before you. I told you that yesterday. The Bible says we share from the nature of God. The Bible said, our God, who dwells in the light that the eyes of the wicked cannot behold. Colossians says, our life is hidden in Christ. He said, and Christ, who is our life, shall appear. He said, because our life is hidden in Christ and Christ is hidden in God. So anybody that is going to kill you will first of all take God, kill God, and take Christ out of God. Are you getting what I'm saying? After you have killed God, he will now kill Christ and take you out of Christ and then kill you. That's the kind of security you carry around. He said, our life who is in Christ is life we is hidden in Christ. And Christ now is hidden in God. And our God is dwelling in a light that the eyes of the wicked can never behold. Nobody can stop your destiny. That's why I told you what to be afraid. Jesus Christ said, I'm going to tell you who to be afraid. Don't be afraid of a man that can kill the body. And the only thing they can do is to stop the body. They can't stop your soul. Don't be afraid of man. He said, I will never leave you. Hebrews chapter 13, verse 5 and 6. I will never leave you nor forsake you. That you may boldly say, I cannot fear what man can do unto me. Someone say, I will not fear of what man can do to me. I will not be afraid. Don't compromise your faith. If you are not a genuine Christian, become one. Don't just put your one leg in, one leg out. Don't be a sinner in church, a saint in church, and sin outside. Because fire is going to test every man. Look at what happens in our nation today. That people are doing worship. And then some people just come with guns and start shooting. Do you think that everybody that they shoot are going to heaven? Some will go straight from church to hell. Don't be a messiah in hell. Are you getting what I'm saying? So number three, this is number four, just keep counting and keep numbering. No matter the number it is on your note. The next point I'm talking about is that be a devotee. A devotee can never compromise. I remember, I grew up, my father said something when I was growing up. His father happens to be an abbot, and his mother he has the effigy of the throne, the effigy that he always sacrificed. And he said, over years he watched this one, there is nothing that this one could. Before he starts everybody, he will first of all start the Ire. Ire, Pierre, Pierre. if he's going to cook 15,000 times a day, he must have that test. How many times have you put that to God last? When Jesus Christ said, do not be worried about what to eat or what to wear, he said, but you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And what will happen? All these things will be what? Will be added. Be a devotee of the kingdom. The Bible said he prayed 3 times a day. How many times do you pray a day? How many times do you study your scripture a day? Some never open their Bible until maybe next Sunday. He comes to church, writes notes, and then throws it away. So even at Foster, they knew he's never, he's a church goer, but he's never part of them. They know. Don't compromise your faith. Stand. And I know that God Almighty is going to keep you. I said that God Almighty will keep in the name of Jesus. If you are going to, we are going to change your nation and change your generation, you change your hostel, be a devotee. Don't compromise. No matter where your friends are going to make up your mind, this is my lifestyle. What you are practicing is against the kingdom. It's not in line with the law of the people that belong to. So I can't do it. You remember that that was the reason why Joseph refused to sleep with the wife of Potiphar. He didn't say, I'm afraid of Potiphar. He will kill me if he had. No. That woman grabbed at his throat. He said, why should I do this great wickedness and what? And sin against God. It's not about his boss, it's about God. If we all have mind about God, we will live holy. That's why you see many people at home is a well-behaved child. When it comes to school, he's a freelance. He's not a freelance yet. You must become a devotee. Let your Christianity be a daily practice. Create some lifestyle. Your prayer life must come. You must create a lifetime of quiet time. In those days that are quiet time, today is dead. It's not even preach of death. Just go and shower. Father, in Jesus' name, as I'm going, bless my father, my children, only 4 of us and nobody else in Jesus' name. I do like this. I can jump out. He's big. When he comes back tonight again, as he was being a very wrong shanda, the Father in Jesus' name, so my blood and your blood. And that man has been living for years. You can't survive like that. You need to look at it. How did David became what he became? He was devoted to 3 times a day prayer. David said, 7 times a day will I appear before you and praise your name. 7 times. How many times do you appear before God? Some of us, the time that every hear your voice, I say, Father! He said, who is talking? He said, he's told you, he said, there is a problem. They know if there is no problem, you never call. So they have already registered his voice as a problem called the devil. When they hear his voice, they say, Tony is calling, so there is a problem. What did you do this time around? Be a devotee. Worship him. Look at the kind of worship that we have this morning. Wonderful. The Lord bless that person. What a glorious atmosphere. Worship him. The Bible says he kneeled down before them and prayed and what? And gave thanks. It was specifically stated there. He gave thanks. Jesus Christ faced the problem. He had to feed 5,000 people. And then he had 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. But so when he received it, he did what? He gave thanks. And bread multiplied. When you live a life of thanksgiving, doors open on its own. I'm about to close, but I want us to check something and pray before we close. Did you hear what I said? So let's read on. Verse 11. The Bible said, then these men assembled and found him and prayed, making supplication before his God. Then they came near and stayed before the king concerning the king's decree. Hast thou not signed a decree that every man that shall ask a petition of any god or man within 30 days, save of thee, O king, shall be cast into the den of lions? The king answered and said, the thing is true, according to the law of Medes and Persians, which uttered not. Verse 13, then answered they, and said before the king that Daniel, which is of the children of captivity, it doesn't matter your foundation. If you get into the kingdom equalizes everybody. Did you hear what I said? It doesn't matter your foundation, it doesn't matter your beginning. The word of the Lord says your beginning may be small, but your latter should greatly what? Increase. It's the same blood that saved all of us. They are all precious children of God. It doesn't matter how low your life is. Get into the kingdom which equalizes us. The Bible says that God has made the poor to be rich in faith. Why? So that what the rich could do with money, the poor can do it with faith. And what the rich can never do with money, the poor can do it with faith. I would rather be on the side of people that God has given the faith to. You will make it in life. I said you will make it in life. Say, I shall make it. Say it loud and clear to yourself. Say, I shall make it. You shall make it. You are not a moment. You are an empty. You are not. You are not useless. You are useless. He was born out of the captivity, but yet he was preferred above the president. Can you imagine that? Why? An excellent spirit. That's the kingdom spirit. Let's read on. He said, he gathered not the king, O king, nor the decree that thou hast signed, but maketh his petition 3 times a day. Verse 14. Then the king, when he heard these words, was so displeased with himself, and set his heart on David to deliver him. And he labored till the going down of the sun to deliver him. Then these men assembled unto the king, and said unto the king, Know, O king, that the law of the Medes and Persians is that no decree or statute which the king establishes may be changed. Then the king commanded that they brought David and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spake and said unto David, Thy God, which thou givest fighteth, how continually, what will happen? We deliver thee. When people will look at you, what are they linking with? The people said, we can't rob this diamond except we make a law that we push it against his God. They need his God. When people see, what did they link you with? Trust it. Drunkards. Yahoo. I went to a mechanic workshop sometimes ago to go and do my car. And they were greeting a young man there. And said, they call his name, I'm a fool, you're here now. And the guy said, ha. He said, ah, in fact, Oluwayomi, that was the time that some people came and then there was a prison break at Olukuta in Apure, and some prisoners escaped. And police would pull, and they went to town, they were looking for prisoners. And then they saw this guy, he was pulling bike, and as he was going, one of them just stopped and he said, take it, he said, when I dropped the bike and jumped inside the bush, he said, I was looking for a barber shop to scrape my hair. He knew by himself that it was the hair that made him to be suspicious that it was a prisoner. When people look at your dress as a kingdom citizen, what would they actually make you? They said about Daniel, he said, Daniel, the God whom you serve, let me tell you, if you are going to make it in the kingdom, you must be a kingdom father. That's number next, or number four, number five, number next. You must serve in the kingdom. Exodus chapter 23 says, you shall serve the Lord your God. This is you mean. It's a compulsory thing. You shall serve the Lord your God. He will bless your bread and your water and take sickness away from the midst of you. And he will make sure that the numbers of your days, you will do what? You fulfill it. And I declare over your life, you will not go in the midst of your day. I say you will not go in the midst of your day. The numbers of your days, you will fulfill. He said, with long life, I will satisfy you. And show them my salvation. In the book of Job, chapter 36, verse 11, he said, if they serve him and obey him, they shall spend their days in prosperity and years in pleasure. God has provision for people that serve him. I don't know any kind of organization that is well organized like the kingdom servant. You serve the government for 30 something years, you have to write. Move from one office to another office, move to this office and that office, and then you are saying, hey, I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to say, okay, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, I'm going to say, you sit here for 1.5 years. After 35 solid years of service with all his life, they have useless everything in it and dumped him for his family. You can't serve in the kingdom and be dumped. That is the fact. Let your pastor fall, let your life give service unto God. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 12, verse 1, it said, be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. It said, I beseech you therefore, brethren, that you present your body as a living sacrifice, only and acceptable unto God. He said, this one is what? Your reasonable service. Every other service without your only living is a useless service. First of all, let your body be presented. Paul was talking about people of Macedonia. In the book of Ephesians, in the book of Philippians, he said they were excellent people. He said they gave the beyond their life. They still pressurize us. Even out of the abundance of their poverty, they pressurize us to receive. 2 Corinthians chapter 8. He said they pressurize us, begging us to receive. He said, but when I observe them well, it's not just that they gave their properties, but they have given themselves unto God. Until your life is sold out, you can't give him the best part. If they put a particular thing that you are going to complain, I don't have time. If the day you know that you are not one of the time, you are going to now to use it well. The king said to Daniel, the God that you serve, not once in a while, but how? Continually. Someone say continually. Talk to me, church. Continually. One of the powerful words in faith is the word continuity. Paul said unto Timothy, continue the things which thou hast learned. Continue. In the book of Matthew, the disciples came to Jesus and said, send these people out. Let them go and look for something to eat. And Jesus Christ said, I cannot send them out fasting. He said, lest when they are going on the way, they faint on the way. He said, because I have compassion on them, for they have continued with me for now for 3 days. Continue with God. The Bible says, when you start in Galatians chapter 6, he said, because you will receive the reward of the things the seed you have sown when the time is right. And let me tell you, there is a timing for your answer. Some of you have been given your time, given your heart, given your life. Some of you have not given anything to God. You have been in this campus, you have never affected any life, you have not done anything for Christ. I'm calling you to get into the kingdom side. Be responsible. In the kingdom of God, we are responsible people. Praise God. We are not lazy care people. We are not just gathering for nothing. We are gathering for something. We are making impact. Praise God. Make an impact in this campus for God. And I know for sure he will lift you. I say we lift you. So the king said unto Daniel, he said, Daniel, the God whom you serve continually will deliver you. Let's read further verse 17. He said that his tongue was brought and laid upon the mouth of the dead. And the king sealed it with his own signet. Verse 17. He said, and the king sealed it with his own signet and with the signet of his lord, that the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel. Then the king went to his palace and passed the night fasting. Neither were the instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep went from him. Verse 19. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel and said, King, and the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God whom thou servest out continually able to deliver thee from the lions? Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God hath sent his angel and has shut the lion's mouth that they have not hurt me. For as much as before him, innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, as I done nothing. Hallelujah, somebody. He is able, abundantly able, to deliver and to save. He is able, abundantly able, to deliver those who trust in him. The king ran very early in the morning and said, Daniel, I knew that the king was not expecting what he got. When God is in your support, the enemy will be disappointed. One with God is not majority, is more than majority. Team up with God. The Bible says, with men it is impossible, but not with God. For with God all things are what? But not, he said, with men, that's plural. It is impossible. Mark chapter 10, I think verse 27. With men, That's men, all of us here. It is impossible. But with God, all things are what? Are possible. He said, Daniel, with a lamentable voice, because he never expected it. Is the God that you serve able to deliver you? And then the voice came from the pit and said, my God has sent his angel. And I declare over your life, you will disappoint your enemy. I say you will disappoint your enemy. Those who are looking for your downfall, you will disappoint them. Because you will succeed. He said, my God, whom I serve, has sent his angel. Let me tell you, angelic ministration is real. Look at what Pastor shared with us. Just some few inches. Don't let me say it that. Few inches to the pole, they can't stop. What stopped it is not coincidence, the angel. He said, I will give my angels charge over you to carry you in what? In their hands, so that you not dash your foot against it. He said, my God has sent the angelic ministry is real. You will enjoy it this year. You will see this year. It's real. Angelic ministry is real. He said, the angel of God has sent this angel. And that angel has delivered me, has shut the mouth, it has padlocked the mouth of the lion. And let me tell you, the lion of this world will never hurt you. When you serve the Lord, when you get your life devoted to God, when you get yourself dedicated to his service, the lion of this world can never hurt you. I say can never hurt you. The lion of the Yahoo can never hurt you. No evil shall come near you. No place I come near your dwelling. You can see the reward of wisdom, but it will not come near you. The Bible said you shall be far from oppression, but it shall never come near you. He said, touch not my anointed and do my prophet no harm. I am declaring over your life, no one can touch you. He said, whosoever touches you touches the apple of my eye. You are the apples of the eyes of God. Somebody say amen to that. The depth of the security is what God has given to you. Then he said that God has sent his angel. He has padlocked the mouth of the lion. They can never hurt me. This God will serve. Now, wow. You remember the three Hebrew men that dared the Lord the king? And the king said, multiply that fire by itself. And they multiplied the fire. And they carried them. The men who carried them were slain by the heat, not the fire, the heat. Killed them at the mouth. And they threw the three Hebrew men. The basket, they landed in the fire. The robe that belongs to the king of Babylon was burnt. Their whole clothes was not touched. The basket, the hair of their head was never stretched. God will keep you. I said, God will keep you. Get your life devoted to this God. Get your life dedicated. Your body, your soul, your spirit, your time, your money. In this campus, use it for God. Let God take over. If somebody here hear what I'm saying, and I'm telling you, he will never disappoint you. He did it in disappointing you, he will never disappoint you. He never disappoint the three improvement, he won't disappoint you. He never disappoint Moses, he won't disappoint you. He never disappoint Elijah, he won't disappoint you. Somebody shout a louder, amen. We are about to pray, get ready. He said, my God has sent his angel and has padlocked the mouth of the lion. Let's look at what he said again. Look at it. Where are we now? That's what now? 22. Okay? He said, my God has sent his angel. Okay? And has shut the lion's mouth. Why could the lion not utter? Because he's the son of the lion of Judah. Have you ever thought why fire could not consume the three Hebrew men? Because our God is a consuming fire. When his son entered fire, fire spoke to fire. When his son entered the lion's den, the lion of Judah spoke to other lions. That is the son of who you are. You are the son of the king. I say you are the son of the king. I say you are the son of the king. Somebody shout hallelujah. Verse 23 says, then was the king exceeding glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken out of the den, and no manner of fault was found upon him. Why? Because he believed in God. The last point I'm giving to you, develop your faith in God. With God, all things are what? Are possible. If only you can believe all things. If you believe you can come out with great behavior in this campus, it's possible. With God. Do you believe that you can have scholarship throughout? It's possible. Do you believe after your schooling here, job will be waiting for you? It's possible. So if that believe all things are what? Are possible. A woman touched the garment of Jesus, and Jesus Christ said, be unto you according to what? Your faith. He didn't say, be unto you according to my power. He didn't say, my power has made you. He said to her, your faith has what? Has made you. What happened to you is by the virtue of what you believe. If you have been believing wrong, you start believing like it. That's why you need to understand the kingdom you belong. It is only the will of God that is permitted in your life. Let me tell you, people of God, anytime you see something happening that is not in line with the will of God. What is the will of God? The will of God is here. If it's not in line with the will of God, you have a right to rise and stand against it. You have a say in that matter. He said, I will give to you the keys of the kingdom, and whatever you bind on the earth shall be what? Bound in heaven. Whatever you loose on the earth shall be what? Loose in heaven. The devil is attacking you with sickness. Tell that devil, I am not here. I don't have time for that. I serve the Lord. He shall take away sickness from the midst of me, and may bless my bread and water. You can't catch cholera. You can't catch bread for you. Do you hear what I said? He blesses your bread and what? And water. He blesses your bread and water. When he's blessed, he's blessed. Develop your faith. Let your faith be built by the word of God. The Bible says faith comes by hearing, and hearing by what? By the word of God. Faith does not come by hearing newspaper. It comes by hearing the word of God. By hearing and hearing. Someone say hearing and hearing. Talk to me. Say hearing and hearing. Hearing. Develop your faith. Number one thing that I said to you, if you are going to affect the kingdom of God, number one, get the Holy Spirit. Number two, be diligent. Number three, be faithful to God. Be committed. Be a devotee. Number three, be committed to kingdom service. Number four. And then number five, develop what? Your faith. Build your faith. The disciples were on the sea, and the thing was raging here and there. And then they shouted, Master, how come that you didn't care that we perish? Jesus Christ said, why did you? He said, why are you afraid? Oh, you of little faith. Your faith can change anything in this world. Get your faith straight out of God. If God promises you, he will do it. Whatever he has said, that is what he's going to do. He will surprise you this year. As we close, look at that verse 25. He said, then Darius wrote unto all the nation. Okay, verse 24. He said, them and the king commanded that they brought those men which had accused Daniel, and they cast them into the den of lions, and them and their children and their wives, and the lions had mercy of them, and break all their bones and pieces, or ever they came at the bottom of the den. Let me give you a warning here. Whatever you are doing today, we have implications not only on you alone, but upon the family. They were the ones that gathered together against Daniel to pass. They never thought that man is going to survive. They didn't know that the God of the kingdom where he came from is that power. They never knew. But after the whole matter, the king commanded as they bring those men. After they brought them, said, don't leave their wives behind. Whatever you are doing today, we have implication on your family. Be careful. Be careful. You are young today. You can prepare future for yourself. But any seed you are sowing today, your children will eat out of it. The Bible said they treat the father as ate the unripe fruit, and the teeth of the children is set at fault. Our Baba Jesu in Kawa. Any one of you that is suffering from the consequences of the sin of the father, this morning God will have mercy upon you. This morning God will send deliverance to you. And I want you to pray that prayer before God. He said, the soul that sells, that shall die. But there are some things that when you do it, it has implications on children that you are going to give birth to. I told some of my people in the ministry, I said, you know the reason why you have to make it. Some of you, your father, your parent has brought you to this level where you are. You must not take it down for your children. Neither must you let it be like this for your children. Fight and succeed so that your children can succeed better. The pastor, the king commander, said, bring those men, bring their children, bring their wives, bring their property, and they threw them inside the lion's den so that they will not think that the lion was fake. I think I had a story of a particular young girl. He said he was in class, and then the teacher was teaching them, and that teacher just digressed. I was talking about that. How many of you here, you believe you go to church? And then he said, they are just visiting you in church. He said, they told you that most of the children of Israel, they walk through the Red Sea. He said, it's not true. Red Sea is not that deep. He said, it's just up to the knee of the people there. So they just walk through. And one little guy just raised up his hand. And said, if it is not a miracle that the children of Israelite passed through the sea, then it's a miracle that the same sea, Egyptians sank there with their child. God will always leave a witness behind. So that they will not think that the lions were fake. They commanded and threw them. The Bible said before they landed, the lion drew in and made them on the air and tore them apart. We saw it concerning Haman and Mordecai yesterday. The garland that was made for Mordecai, Haman was down angrily. The word of the Lord says, anyone that diggeth a pit for you shall fall into it. Anyone that set a trap shall enter into it. And I declare over your life, whatever area the enemy has shooting arrow against you, I declare battle sender. I say battle sender. I say battle sender. In the name of Jesus, you will prevail over your enemies. You will prevail over your enemies. The Bible says we are more than conquerors through him that loveth us. The Bible says greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. I declare from today to become a conqueror. No matter where they arrange a battle against you, they will go with their battle. If not, they will come against you one way, they will flee away from you seven ways. I declare over you today, let the victory come to you in the name of Jesus. You will see their hands. You will see their hands. You will see their hands. Rise to your feet and begin to pray. Rise to your feet and begin to pray. No trap, no power of the enemy over can shadow you. You shall track upon serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy. Nothing shall the enemy sought you. You belong to the kingdom that cannot be dominated. You are a citizen of the kingdom. You are a citizen of the kingdom. Whatever arrow that is shot against you, battle sender, I shoot it off by the power in the name of Jesus. I am undefeatable. I'm untouchable. I'm unkillable. I'm unstoppable. I am a citizen of the kingdom. Pray. I'm more than conqueror. I walk over the Sabbath. I walk over the battles. Whatever plot the enemy has arranged against my life, I will not, it will not capture me. I will not fall into their ditch. In the name of Jesus, he that thinketh a peace shall fall into it by the power. In the name of Jesus, lift the voice and pray. Any arrows shot against your life, we declare battle sender, by the power and the name of Jesus. I'm a citizen of the kingdom. I'm a citizen of the kingdom. Rosha Tapramasule, Rosha Debe Bramasule, Rosha Sekepolo Pramasanda Brava, Remo Mosunda Brava Lebodia Mastulia. Anywhere blood is going on, avenge your life. When they clap at the Father, name of Jesus, let them carry it with their head. Let them carry it with their head. Let them carry it with their head. I'm devoted into the kingdom. I'm a citizen of the kingdom. By the power and the name of Jesus, my strength is from Astolia. Rema, my shanda, brahma, nerebo. No weapon that formed against me shall prosper. Every thought fight up against me, I shall condemn them. Everywhere they gather against my life, I condemn them. I bring them under judgment of God. By the power and the name of Jesus, my strength is from Astolia. I am more than conqueror. I'm an overcomer. In the name of Jesus. Rema shonda brama le debo, repete que polo costolia. Rosanda brama le debo riamasta le brama le debo. Rema mama shenda pro costolia mashanda brama le debo. Rema mama shanda brama le debo riamastolia. Rema baba brama shanda brama le debo. Rema mazende pro molo de brama stolia. Yes Lord, yes Lord, yes Lord, yes Lord, yes Lord. I walk over the mountains. I walk over the problem. I walk over the serpent. I shook away the sickness. It's not my portion. I shook away failure. It's not my portion. I shook away frustration. It's not my portion. I shook it away. Every limitation in my life, I shook it away. In the name of Jesus, I'm unlimited. I'm unstoppable. I'm unblockable. I'm unkillable. By the power, in the name of Jesus, I'm a kingdom citizen. Yes, Lord. Process the promise to me. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. For the dead could not hold them captives, heaven in the grave. Oh, Jesus is Lord. For the dead could not hold them captives, oh, heaven in the grave. Oh, yes, Jesus is Lord. My soul. God mark me by the Lord. Oh, my spirit! Spirit, I call them forth. And wherever plot is going on against you, to kill you, to tie you down, to limit your destiny. I declare today, let the judgment of God come against them. In the name of Jesus. No weapon that fashion against you shall prosper. Every tongue slicing up against you, they are condemned. I declare today, you are winner. You are conqueror. You are lifted. In the name of Jesus. Let me just read this verse. I'm close. I'm done. Verse 25 says, then King Darius wrote unto all the people, nations, and languages that dwell in all the earth, these be multiplied unto you. I make a decree that in every dominion of my kingdom, men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel. Your God will be glorified.
I say your God will be glorified. The king said, for he is the living God, and is the only one that is steadfast forever. His kingdom, somebody say his kingdom. His kingdom, that which shall not be destroyed, and his dominion shall be given unto them. He delivereth and rescueth and worketh signs and wonders. That God will perform signs and wonders in your life. In heaven and on the earth, who has delivered Daniel from the power of the lion? So Daniel prospered. 2019, you will prosper. When men are looking for your downfall, God will lift you above. The Bible says promotion coming now from east nor west, prophet the Lord. The Lord lifted up one and picked up the other. Out of men that have been lifted 2019, your name is included. Your name is included. Your name is included. 2019, you shall prosper. Then you prosper even in the midst of your persecution, you will prosper. In the name of Jesus. Lift your hands and just begin to worship the Lord. Lift your hands and worship. Lift your hands and worship.
For the dead could not hold him back. I hold him back.
Lift your hands and worship.
Jesus is God. Oh, for the land. For the world. My soul, my lips are